Hello children, how are you? I hope you all are happy and healthy. So children, I will recite a poem and you will have to listen to it and then tell me what we are going to talk about today. Okay children, so listen carefully and sing along. Tick tick tock, tick tick tock, tick tick tock, says the clock. Tick tick tick, tick tick tick, seconds hand says, please be quick. Tick says a minute, tock says an hour, clock tells us that time has power. Keep on working, never stop, one day you will be on top. Tick tick tock, tick tick tock, tick 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 tock. So children, tell me, what are we going to talk about today? Tick tick tick. I think you know it now. Something that has numbers written on it. And some moving hands which point towards these numbers. And their hands keep on moving round and round and round and round. So, yes, today we are going to talk about time or clock that says tick, tick, tick. So, let's sing once again. Tick, tick, tock, tick, tick, tock, tick, tick, tock, says the clock. Tick, tick, tick. Tick, 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 seconds hand says, please be quick. Tick says a minute, tock says an hour, clock tells us that time has power. Keep on working, never stop, one day you will be on top. So tell me children, does a clock actually says tick, tick, tick? Have you ever heard this sound? If no, then look here carefully and listen to it. Tick, tick, tick. So tell me, which hand of the clock is making this sound? Yes, this thin, long, fast-moving hand. Do you know what does it show? It shows seconds. Tick, tick, tick. Let's count. But from where should we start counting? Are there any numbers in the clock? If yes, then where are they starting from? Very good. From 1. Very good. And which is the last number? It's 12. Yes, from 1 to 12. Right at the top is 12. So let's start from here only. Suppose our seconds hand starts moving from here. From 12 to its right side. We will see how many times it says tick, tick, tick to reach back to its starting point. So, let's count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30. 31, 32, 33, 34, 35, 36, 37, 38, 39, 40, 41, 42, 43, 44, 45, 46, 47, 48, 49, 50, 51, 52, 53, 54, 55, 56, 57, 58, 59, 60. Yes, 60 in one round. These were the seconds. 60 seconds. It took 60 seconds to complete one round. So tell me, how many seconds to reach 1? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 seconds. And to reach 2, it will take 10 seconds. For 3, 15. For 4, 20. For 5, 25. Oh wow, it looks like the table of 5. 5 ones are 5, 5 twos are 10, 5 threes are 15, 5 fours are 20, then 25, 30, 35, 40, 45, 50, 55 and 60. And it completes the 60 seconds. One completed round of this tick tick hand. Okay, now tell me, what do 60 seconds make all together? 60 seconds equals to 1 minute. Look at the other hand, this long one. Does this one also move? Look, right now it is at 12. Exact 12. So, let us now have a look at one more round of this seconds hand. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Tick, 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 10. Tick, 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 15. Tick, 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 20. Tick, 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 25. Tick, 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 30. Tick, 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 35. Tick, 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 40. Tick, 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 45. Tick, 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 50. Tick, 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 55. Tick, 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 60. One complete round, that is 60 seconds. Now see this long hand. Did it move? Yes, look, it has moved away from 12 and has reached at this first line. So it makes 1 minute. 60 seconds equal to 1 minute. If the seconds hand will complete one more round, then the minute hand will move to the next line. That will mean 2 minutes. So tell me, how many minutes will it take to reach the number 1? Count these lines. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So 5 minutes. The tick-tick hand takes only 5 seconds to reach there. But this one takes 5 minutes. That is 5 completed rounds of seconds hand. Oh, how slowly it moves. Okay, tell me, how much time will it take to complete one round of the clock? 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35, 40, 45, 50, 55, 60. It means 60 minutes. Oh, 60 minutes. That makes 1 hour. Would you like to wait that long and see? Oh no, it will take a lot of time. 1 whole hour. Do you know this smaller hand? That is, which shows hours. It takes 1 whole hour to move from one number to the next. 1 whole hour. Oh, it's the slowest of them all. Okay, let's see what is the time right now. For that, we will see only the hours and the minutes hands. Because seconds hands, it moves really fast. So see, hours hand is at 12. First hours and then minutes. And in between these two dots, like this. So for hours, we will write 12. And the bigger hand, that is the minute hand, is also at 12. So 0 minutes. We also start from here, so 0 minutes. So 12 hours and 0 minutes. It's 12 o'clock. And now it's 1 o'clock. So minutes hand has completed one more round. And now 2 o'clock. Okay, now tell me, what is the time? Little hand is at 2. So we will write 2. And bigger hand is at 6. So 30 minutes. I hope you remember. 6 multiplied by 5 equals to 30. Now tell me, where is the little hand? At 3 or at 4? It is in the middle of both. Because bigger hand is about to complete its round. It is at 9. When it will reach at 12? That will mean one more completed hour. And thus, little hand will have to reach 4. So tell me now, how many hours are there right now? We will write 3. Because it is about to reach 4, but has not reached yet. So let's write 3 for hours. And for minutes? Minutes are 45. 9 multiplied by 5 equals to 45. So time here is 3. 3:45. And now tell the time. 7 and 4 fives are 20. 7:20. Yes, and here 7:30. This clock says 9 and 8 fives are 40. So 9:40. Very good. And now it's 7:10. Now look here. Here, Pamposh and Shazia are talking to each other. That who lives farther from the school?
I have to walk for 5 minutes to reach school.
And I have to walk for just 2 minutes to reach school.
That's not possible. Your home is much farther than my home.
But I have checked in my watch. I leave home at 7 for school, and when I reach the school, the minute hand is there at 2. So that means 2 minutes past 7.
So children, could you understand where is Shazia mistaken? She says that when she reaches school, then the time is 7:02. Because minute's hand is at 2. Like this. So if this hand is at 5, so does that mean 5 minutes? And if it is at 10, then 10 minutes. And if it is at 12, then 12 minutes. So does an hour has only 12 minutes? But we all know that 1 hour has 60 minutes. Okay, tell me, how many hours are there in one day? 10, 12 or 24? Yes, one day has 24 hours. That is from 12 midnight today to 12 midnight tomorrow will be 24 hours. So tell me then that why does this clock has numbers till 12 only? Why not till 24? This is because the hour's hand takes 2 rounds of the clock in one day. 12 midnight to 12 noon. And then from 12 noon to 12 midnight. So that makes 24 hours. Here Pamposh said,
24 hours in one day and 60 minutes in each hour.
So where are those 60 minutes? Here number are only till 12.
Come, let's have a closer look at the watch. See here, we have some more marks other than these numbers. Look at these small lines. Come, let's count the lines that are between 12 and 1. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And now between 1 and 2. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Here also 5. Between every two numbers, we have a distance of 5 lines only. So how many such lines in total? So from 12 till 12, there will be 12 multiplied by 5 equals to 60 lines.
Okay, so here are the minutes.
When you reached school, the minute's hand was at 2. So that means 2 multiplied by 5, that is 10 minutes. You reach school at 7:10. So can you tell me, what is the time by this watch right now?
3 multiplied by 5 equals to 15. So here, the time is 7:15. 15 minutes past 7.
Wow, Shazia got it now. But see, here 3 friends are looking at the same clock but telling different times. So tell me, who out of these is right? Chiku, Bittu or Pinky? Look at the first clock. Here, little hand is at 3 and bigger hand is at 12. So time will be 3 o'clock. But Chiku said 12, 3. Oh no, how is that possible? At 12, we have the bigger hand. It shows minutes, not the hours. Chiku has done it all wrong. He did not even write the correct minutes. At least, he should have multiplied 3 by 5. He has also repeated the Shazia's mistake. All wrong. Let us see Bittu's answer. 12, 15. Oh no, he has also reversed the numbers. He took hour's hand for minutes and minutes hand for hour's hand. This is also wrong. Only Pinky has given the right answer. Well done, Pinky. Let's go further. First hours, then minutes. So first little hand and then bigger hand. So find out the little one. At 5. And the bigger one at 7. So minutes will be 35. 7 multiplied by 5 equals to 35. So the correct time is 5:35. Let's see whose answer is correct. Chiku said 7:25. Oh no, again the wrong hands. And see, Bittu has correctly seen the hours hand, but has written 7 minutes. Again Shazia's mistake. Why do these children always forget the multiplication by 5? They should write these numbers on their watches. 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35, 40, 45, 50, 55 and 60. I hope you all remember to multiply by 5 for minutes. So let us look at the next clock. Tell me the time. Fast. 7:15. Well done. Chiku and Bittu are still repeating the same mistakes again and again. They must correct their mistake. Only then they will be able to tell the right time. So here, all the correct answers have been given by Pinky only. She knows it very well. First hours, then minutes. First little hand, then bigger one. And for minutes, multiply by 5. Now, let's draw the hands of clock according to some given time. Here we have 3:10, 6:40, 10:50, 4:15, and 9:55. Very good, children. Okay, tell me, when does a new day begin? 6 o'clock, 5 o'clock, or 7 o'clock? No, that's the time of sunrise, or our wake-up time. Does the sun rise every morning at the same time? And also sets at the same time? If yes, then why do we have smaller days in winters? Are you able to play outside for long in winters also? No, the sun sets early. Come, let's make a table. In this table, we will write the time of sunrise and sunset for all the 7 days of the previous week. For this, you will have to look at the newspapers. For the whole week, there you will easily find the time of sunrise and sunset. See, like this. Now, let us complete the table. First, write the names of days. Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday and Sunday. Now look at the newspapers and fill it. You will see that every day the time of sunrise and sunset varies. You know what? At different places also, the time of sunset and sunrise is different. Look at this picture and try to guess. What will be the time here? Maybe 6 or 7 in the evening. But do you know, children? Here the time is 9 p.m. And see how much light is there? At our place, it gets quite dark at 9 o'clock. Actually, this is the picture of Paris. There, sometimes the sun sets at 4 o'clock. In the afternoon, and sometimes it sets at 9 or 10 at night. Isn't it magical? So now you know, children, actually a new day is counted from 12 o'clock at midnight, that is 12 midnight, and after that 1 a.m., 2 a.m., 3 a.m., 4 a.m., 5 a.m. This way till 12. We use AM for this. The meaning of AM is antimeridian. You may say the time of rising sun. And at 12 o'clock, that is 12 noon, At this time, the sun is right above our head. After that, it starts setting towards the west. So for the time after 12 noon, we write PM, that is post-meridian. 1 PM, 2 PM, 3 PM, etc. till the 12 midnight. Isn't that interesting? Okay, let me tell you another interesting fact. At some places, the timetables follow a 24-hour clock in place of 12 hours, like railways, airplanes, etc. It means after 12 noon, instead of starting again from 1, they continue from 12 only. That is, for 1 PM, they will write 13, and for 2 PM, they will write 14, and so on. So do you know what happened once? Once there was a child. His name was Tutun. He went to his grandparents with his parents in his summer vacations. He enjoyed a lot there. Do you also go to your grandparents? Then do you feel like coming back from there? No, not at all. So Tutun did not want to come back. But their ticket has been booked already. Mummy told him that their train will leave at 5:30 in the evening. They reached station in time. Tutun was sad. He wanted to miss the train. But how was that possible? They still had 15 more minutes. But then Tutun's father told them something. And Tutun started dancing with joy. Do you know what did his father say? He said that the station master says our train was scheduled for 5:30 in the morning, not evening. They write 17:30 for 5:30 in the evening because they use a 24-hour clock. Tutun's parents were very upset, but Tutun was very happy. You must have understood now how they made this mistake. It was because of the 24-hour clock. Tutun is still dancing with joy. So children, if you are going to travel by train, then always take care of this fact. Okay, see, here on the ticket, they also write the date. Do you know how to read a date? See here, we have 15, 5, 20. It shows the day, month and the year. So let's begin from the right side. 20. This is the year. Look at this calendar. This is of the year 2020. So we will write 2020 for all the dates of this year. Now let us look at the next number. 5. This is the month. So tell me which month is there at the fifth number? January, February, March, April, May. So the month of May. And here, at first place, the number of days is written, 15. That means 15th day of May. See, it's here in the calendar. So we may write 15th of May 2020. Now, let us look at some more dates. 7-6-2020. So it will be January, February, March, April, May, June. Yes, 7th of June 2020. So let's write some such dates back in the number form. 1st of June 2019. So we will write 1-06 for June and then 19. So 1-6-19. Next is 10th of August 2018. So 10, 8 for August and then 18. So 10, 8, 18. Will these dates ever benefit you? Yes, they will definitely help you. Do you know how? Tell me, do you ever eat chips or chocolates? Have you ever seen any date written on their wrappers? This time, when you will eat something bought from the market, make sure to check the date written on it. It will tell you whether it is fit for eating or not. It's not right to eat something older than a given date. In case of fever or cough, you must have taken some syrups. It also has some dates written on it, its manufacturing and expiry date. Before taking these medicines, this date should also be checked. It's very easy. You can find out for yourself. So now, let's play some games with the help of a clock. We need to do all these tasks in 1 minute only. Tell me, how will you know about 1 minute from the clock? It will be the one complete round of the tick-tick hand. You know that, right? Let's start. Click your fingers. So let's see who clicks for maximum number of times in 1 minute. And now, skipping a rope. How many times can you skip a rope in 1 minute? Clapping with your hands. So children, think of some more such games and play with your friends, like counting or reading words. Hey, we can play it like this also. That for how long can we do a particular task, like speaking non-stop? Note the time before starting and then also note the time when you stop. Then check for how long could you do it. Balancing on one leg. That will be fun. Note the time and try to do it. Or maybe jumping on one leg? Wow, we will have lots of fun. Well, children, that means we can find out the time taken by any given task. Like for how long did we sleep? Note the time before sleeping. Suppose 10 p.m. Then note the time when you wake up. Suppose 6 a.m. So for how many hours did you sleep? 10 p.m. to 12 midnight. That will be 2 hours. Then from 12 to 6 a.m. It will be 6 more hours. So 2 plus 6 equals to 8 hours. We can play a game with this also. First, make a guess and then try to do it. First, think of some task that is done by someone else. Like mother boils the milk in the morning. To boil the milk. Now guess the time it will take. I think boiling of milk will take 15 minutes. So now we will check it. Suppose mummy keeps the milk for boiling at 7 a.m. And according to me, it will be boiled in 15 minutes. So tell me what will be the time then? 7 a.m. Then after 15 minutes, it will be 7:15. Now cross-check it in the morning. Now think of some other tasks. For example, filling water in a bucket or watching your favorite cartoon. Making a picture of a clock and coloring it. Making some other picture. Preparing tea or cooking dinner. Your sports period. Is that also equal to the other periods? Check it out. And the recess period. Oh, it looks so small. Because that's full of fun. Well, children, now some questions. First of all, tell me, how many months are there in 1 year? That's right, 12. So now tell me their names also. January, February, March, April, May, June, July, August, September, October, November, December. How many days are there in a week? 7 days. And their names? Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday. How many hours are there in a day? How many minutes are there in an hour? How many seconds in a minute? What do we need to do to convert the time in a 12-hour clock into that in 24-hour clock? We will just have to add 12 in the number of hours. Well done, children. I wonder as to who has discovered this clock, who used only 12 numbers to show 24 hours of a day, 60 minutes of an hour, and also the 60 seconds of a minute with that fast moving tick-tick hand. So, did you see, children? That's the magic of mathematics. Well, children, now we will meet in the next chapter. Till then, keep studying and keep practicing. Thank you. Have a nice day.